Before we get into Silent Hill 4, we have to address a big fat misnomer that is annoying us to no end. With Silent Hill 3 came a brand new nickname for the cult. In room S1 of the third floor of Brookhaven Hospital, there is an article which refers to Silent Hill's cult as...
The Order.
We refuse to call them that. Naming the cult implies that someone other than its members knows about it.
This is exactly why they were unnamed in Silent Hill 1 and 2.
It gives the cult an air of mystery. Nevertheless, the memo reads,
"The cult religion that operates Hope House is known by the locals simply as
The Order."
In the original Japanese, written by Hiroyuki Owaku, the memo reads, "Kibō no ie wo unei suru shin no dantai de aru kono kato shukyō wa, rokuji no namae wa naku, jimoto de wa tada kyōdan to yobarete iru."
This sentence is really translated.
Hope House is really a religious cult which is run by a group that does not have its own name, but is simply called Kyodan, or the cult.
So when Jeremy Blaustein translated his sentence, when localizing the game, Kyodan, the cult, became...
The Order.
This is because Mr. Blaustein sees Kyodan as a semi-official title, and so must be translated as such. When in reality, Kyodan is just the word cult.
This name was carried over to Silent Hill 4 in the memo Joseph's Article, which is a direct copy of the Silent Hill 3 article with the word wish substituted for hope. This further cemented Blaustein's translation as the official name, much to our frustration.
In any case, it doesn't really matter how this little nickname came about. We're going with the original Japanese and leaving them unnamed as was intended.
Whoa. Nice.
Are you in there, Henry? This is the superintendent. Is anybody home?
The story of the room is about Walter Sullivan, a serial killer we learned about in Silent Hill 2. Walter was an accident born in apartment 302 of the South Ashfield Heights apartment building in South Ashfield.
Oh, shut the hell up! You can't blame it all on me. Little crybaby. I told you we shouldn't have a baby, didn't I?
His parents abandoned him, and the super, Frank Sunderland, had to put Walter into an orphanage. The orphanage Walter ended up in is Hope Wish House, where Silent Hill's cult members kidnap children and brainwash them into believing the cult's teachings. Walter was told by Dahlia Gillespie during one of her visits to Wish Hope House that his mother is in the apartment where he was born. She tricked him into believing that performing the 21 sacraments for the descent of the Holy Mother would allow him to see his mother, when actually the ritual would bring about the rebirth of the Holy Mother.
October 16th. Some important people came today. One of them, it's cut off, I can't read anymore. October 17th. The important lady told me my mother was asleep in Ashfield. I have a mother too. I'm so happy. I want to see my mother. Where is Ashfield anyway? October 21st. Sunday is the day I leave the round cell to read the book. I read very well today. If I can do a good job reading the 21 sacraments for the descent of the Holy Mother, I can meet my mother. The important lady told me that, but tomorrow I'm going to the round cell again.
This seems to be another way to summon God, but if so, why would Dahlia tell Walter this if she's already taking care of that plan with her own daughter?
Maybe she wanted a backup plan.
Why would she need a backup plan if the Alessa plan was air tight?
The 21 sacraments involves killing 21 people who each represent something, separating them from their bodies, including Walter, which is how he's able to continue on after killing himself. The ritual also turns the apartment in question into a nightmare world of Walter's subconscious. Henry Townsend, the current resident of the apartment, wakes one day to find himself trapped, the door chained up from the inside. He is able to observe the outside world, but cannot interact or escape.
Help! Let me out of here!
There's something going on in this room.
After 10 days, a hole opens up in the bathroom. The hole leads to various parts of Walter's past, including Hope Wish House, and the surrounding area. The cult cylinder prison, where Walter was kept for a short time for misbehaving. The city of South Ashfield. The subway Walter used to get to the apartment. The apartment building itself,
and the hospital in which one of his future victims ends up. All of Walter's victims haunt the realms of his subconscious, and all of his future victims are pulled into his world to be killed.
That's right. This is just a dream. And a really terrible one, too. I hope I wake up soon.
So you think this is a dream, huh?
Well, if it's not a dream, what is it?
Walter inhabits his nightmare world in both his adult and child forms, representing Walter's complete disconnect from his innocence. Walter's last two victims are Henry and his neighbor Eileen Galvin. Henry is helped throughout his ordeal by the ghost of Joseph Schreiber, the previous tenant of 302 and victim of Walter. Joseph informs Henry that he must travel to the deepest part of Walter's subconscious.
I got this letter from him. He told me to go down, down into the deepest part of him.
Reunite his mind with part of his flesh. The umbilical cord, you know, that Sunderland kept.
Umbilical cord I keep in a box in my room. Lately it's started to smell terrible.
Huh?
And there he'll be able to kill Walter and end the nightmare. So he does. Or doesn't. The end. If Walter really wanted to live in Henry's apartment, he could have just... Knock, knock! Hey, can I live here?
What the hell?
Just ask for sugar. And steal an apartment while
Silent Hill 4 had good and bad points. While the story is lacking and nowhere near the quality we've come to expect from the series, it maintains the theme and style of the series and makes for a good side story.